Hey guys, this is a short video of how to sync the SP404 Mark II to the Digitact. I got this idea from Chris Galactic Beats, another YouTube user who used his Digitact to sync to an SP404 SX, and thought I should try the same since some of the sequencing capabilities in the Mark II I'm not really a fan of just yet. It's an amazing device, but to edit the sequence afterwards isn't the easiest to do. You tend to just have to delete the entire sequence in the Mark II and more or less start over. So the Digitact does give you that added flexibility. And let's just get right to it. So in the Mark II, your settings are in Shift Pad 13, and then we go to the MIDI settings, and here basically we're just leaving MIDI sync to auto, MIDI sync out, on, soft through on, and MIDI USB through on. And basically that's all we need to do in there. In the back of the unit here, I have a MIDI cable going into the in of the SX, using the smaller adapter. Now in the Electron unit, in the Digitact unit, we are going to go to MIDI configuration, sync, and have clock send checked and transport send checked and programs and check. Now I'm not entirely sure if you need all three of these checked, but this has been working so far for me, so I'm gonna go back. And what we're gonna do is just cut up a short sequence and sequence it in the 404 Mark II, and then I'm gonna play the Digitact. Use the Digitact to play as the master. So I just chopped that up and assigned them to pads 1 through 16 on bank A. Now I'm just gonna assign those pads to a mute group. And take the gate off of all of them. Thank you. I'm just adjusting the volume here. So drums from the Digitact can hit the compressor a bit better. So if you notice there, it's probably, I might learn a bit about this later, but when I pushed play on the Digitact, the Roland SP404 was automatically in sync, and this pattern isn't blinking. So that's crucial, because if you record your pattern first and you need to select a pattern, the Digitact won't play the 404 if this pad isn't selected or a pad isn't selected. So I had that problem where I was trying to get the Digitact to play and the SP404 Mark II would not play because this pad wasn't selected or it was flashing. So when it's solid, that means the pad is selected and that it will play when I push play on the Digitact. So maybe not too happy with the sequence, but whatever, it's playing what I needed to play with, and I can now tweak on whatever I need to. Thank you. maybe I'll half the sequence. So, yeah, so it only plays a 4-bar sequence. See what happens. I like the first 4 bars. This is what I've discovered. So anyway, maybe you guys could apply that to what you are doing. If you have any questions, maybe I'll see if I can answer with whatever knowledge I have. All right. Thanks, guys.